Hi, this is Dr. Graves from the CSUN Geography Department with a quick video tutorial on graphing temperature and altitude and pressure and altitude. The purpose is twofold. We want you to know a little bit about visualizing scientific data, and two, we think that it will help you better understand the dynamics involved if you are working with the data directly. Okay, so look over here. There's data here about the relationship between temperature and altitude. And the altitudes are in kilometers, so we're talking extremely high altitudes above the Earth's surface. And then we're looking at essentially the thermopause and the tropopause and those sorts of concepts that are probably early on in your textbook. So in order to make a graphic that demonstrates these relationships, place your cursor in cell A1, hold and drag, it's called click and drag, across all of the cells that are in pink. Then click on Insert. From the drop-down menu, select Chart, and a chart will appear showing the relationship between altitude and temperature. This isn't an ideal chart for the data that we want, so in the chart editor, click on Chart Type, the down arrow, which produces a number of alternate chart types, and just click on line chart. And that's pretty much it for this. If your instructor asks for it, you may also want to add an additional line or two to this graphic so that you can demonstrate that you understand where the troposphere and the stratosphere, etc., can be found on this chart. How do you add a horizontal line? Click on Insert. Click on Drawing. The drawing window appears. Click on the line option and drag a line that's straight about the width of the chart that you want. And then you may pick a line color and maybe a dashed line. Click Save and Close. And there's the line. It's over here up in the corner. I'm clicking on it and dragging it. And I will drag it, let's say, to this thermopause here, above which is the thermosphere. And click off, and now you have an image. Now, you probably have several options in terms of submitting the evidence that you can do this to your instructor. You may be asked to make a copy. You can share with your instructor by sending the link here. That's one option. I'll click Done. If you click on the chart and you click Save Image, this dialog window will appear. You can click Save on it, and that gives you a file that you could email or upload to the learning management system like Moodle or Canvas. I'll open it quickly, and there it is. And then you can file and make a copy, do several things with it. So that's part one. I'm going to minimize this graphic over here, move my thermopause bar out of the way. The second graphic that you're going to create is demonstrates or represents the relationship between pressure and altitude at lower altitudes. So once again, highlight the data, this time in gold. Once again, click on insert and chart. And once again, a sort of inappropriate chart comes up. Once again, select from the chart types from the down arrow this chart type, which is a line graph. Let's customize this a little bit. So click on the customize option and let's smooth this line, which takes a little of the jaggedness out of it. And that's pretty much it. But what I think you might find interesting here is on the horizontal axis, which this is one on the bottom, if you open that, those options up, and click once on the log scale, which changes the horizontal axis to a logarithmic scale. But what you can also see that it does is that when the axis is on a logarithmic scale, that the relationship between altitude and pressure becomes a linear relationship as opposed to the curvilinear relationship that appears on the chart. Either one of these is fine, but you're introduced to this notion of the logarithmic scale, which characterizes a lot of interactions in the natural and the human world. And sometimes it's better to visualize the relationship on a logarithmic scale. That completes this video tutorial. Please check with your instructor on the specifics about how they would like your evidence of this particular skill submitted to you.